that allowed him to take a picture that sent him a GPS instantly, that you could start tracking this stuff, and it would make it much easier for the general public, and it would give you the long-term information you need to be able to really show that this is working. Thank you.
Thank you. Harry Shepard.
Shalom. My name is Harry Shepard, and I represent the homeless population. And a lot of the issues that y'all having seem to be coming from the homeless population. I'm out there 24/7, and I see what's going on. You know, and two wrongs don't make a right. The first thing I want to bring up is the issue about having storage units for the homeless to store their property.
Thank you.
You know what I mean? Because if we had storage units, it wouldn't be all over the boardwalk. You know, and I think it's only right for us to have some kind of relationship between the homeless people and the people we're housing, because the homeless people is what bring the art and the flavor to Venice. You know, without the homeless people, Venice would seem kind of empty. You know, and so I think it's only right for, instead of wasting all this money trying to fight against us to help us, we'll have more storage places where we can store our property. Number two is the music regulation. I play music, and we have this person named Jason that's on the beach that constantly calls the police in this broad daylight. And we're playing music, and we're entertaining people that come down and want to be entertained. And he constantly harasses and calls the police, and he used some kind of law saying that we're not allowed to play music over 500 decibels or whatever.
You can wrap it up.
All right, and number three is harassment calls on Friday. When they come clean up the homeless stuff, we take our stuff from the beach and we bring it way up off the beach. And now they are chasing us from the beach and coming wherever we at to get our property. This creates a mentality where the homeless people want to rebel. And you have graffiti, you have junk. People don't care because our stuff is getting stolen. It's, you know what I mean? They telling us that we have to come from Venice to go all the way downtown to pick our stuff up. And when we get down there, our stuff a lot of times is not down there. So all these issues is what's causing this problem. More graffiti, more violence, people getting robbed because it's the way they're treating the homeless people. You know, and that's all I have to say.
Thank you. Go cool.
There's an area here where I live that's had graffiti on the sidewalk for a long time. And I went into your office a couple of times to request a clean, and they went out couple times with a power washer, and they did about as good a job as you can with a pressure washer, but you're not going to get it off the sidewalk without a sandblaster, which is what the city uses. So I wanted to ask request that you get one of those, because you're not going to paint over the sidewalk. I've also seen on the curbs there's a lot of areas where there's graffiti, and those have been painted over, which I guess works, but or anything on concrete or asphalt, I think you really need a sandblaster.
Do you have, just to follow up on that, do you have any thoughts on this, on the anything?
We can get to a certain point off of the pavement with the pressure washer that we have, with our solution and both the pressure. Unfortunately, sometimes it's permeated a little too deep into the concrete, and it still leaves a faint trace. And we're limited, once again, and what he said earlier about the no parking times, that's something that we have to take advantage of, is whenever there's something on a sidewalk, we need the street area to be clear because of the damage that we could cause to people's cars.
I understand if they all that, yeah, but yeah, the question is, you're not going to actually clean it if you don't have a sandblaster.
So let me respond to that. Yeah. I don't know the cost of that equipment, and we would have to take a look at what the cost of that equipment is, whether or not that's something that we would use often enough that it makes sense for our budget. If it does, then we'll look at acquiring that. If it doesn't, then I would look and work with the city to try to find a more efficient mechanism to get them out to address something that we can't. So it's a great note, we'll look into it. I don't know which the answer will be, but we probably can't provide an answer to you today. But thank you for the information, and we'll look into that.
Have you seen the city do that, sandblast?
Yes.
I don't know.
Yeah.
So then that's probably something we...
Taylor.
Okay.
Yeah, well, it did happen. What's the address? In front?
Oh, it's on the corner of Innis Place and Westminster, just like down the alley around the corner from your headquarters.
Do you know which corner, like the northeast?
Right across from the dog park on the, it would be the southwest corner.
Let's leverage Taylor and city.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Would you give Quinn your name and number so that we can follow up with you once we've looked into that?
I'm sorry?
Would you give, kindly give Quinn, raising your hand, your contact information so that we can get back to you? It might take us a while to look into that, but then we can follow up.
Okay, thanks.
All right, Paul, Lori, thanks very much. And please thank all the members of your team too. We really, really appreciate it. Over 1,000 bags of trash and amazing. We're making a big difference and we're going to see.
At what cost?
Okay. Next item is item C, the financial report, and that will be handled by our treasurer, Steve Newman.